Welcome everyone. Today we'll learn about the proactive CPU monitoring feature of Azure App Service platform to debug an app that is consuming high CPU. I am Puneet Gupta and I work on Azure App Service Diagnostics. Let's jump right in. This approach applies to apps running on the dedicated SKU on the Windows stack and can be used for apps using any technology if the underlying technology stack is publishing debug symbols. Recall from the previous video that we identified that demo high CPU was consuming maximum CPU resources. The tool is giving us suggestions on the next troubleshooting steps to apply and is advising us to enable proactive CPU monitoring. Before enabling it, I wanted to give you all a quick overview of the feature. When apps consume high CPU intermittently on one or more instances, it's incredibly hard to debug because you don't know the time or the instances where the issue may happen. But that problem is a thing of the past. Our new innovative feature collects the right data at the right time on the right instance without any user intervention or effort. This feature keeps a close watch on all the processes that are consuming high CPU, and whenever it detects any process crossing the configured threshold, it collects the right data and mitigates the issue by killing the bad process, thereby recovering the high CPU situation. With single-click enablement, you can move all the complexity from your shoulders over to this feature. This feature makes CPU investigation so simple that anyone can debug high CPU issues easily using the approach shown in this video. Let's see how. You enable this tool by clicking on this button, or you can go to the home page of the Diagnose and Solve Problems and click on Diagnostic Tools and click on Proactive CPU Monitoring. When you run it for the first time, it asks you to create or choose a storage account. This is where the data collected via this tool is stored. On enabling the tool, additional options appear that let you configure the tool as per your scenario. We have chosen the default configuration wisely, but you can change these if needed. As per the defaults, when any process under the site takes more than 75% of overall CPU for more than 30 seconds, a dump will be triggered and a maximum of 2 dumps will be collected. The rule will be evaluated every 15 seconds. Once any process hits the condition, the data is collected, the bad process is terminated, and the new one starts automatically. Enabling monitor web job option allows monitoring web jobs as well. You can view the summary of the rule configured, and if everything looks fine, enable the monitoring. Once the monitoring is enabled, you can see the status of the rule and data collected. Shortly, instance level logs appear that let you view the CPU monitoring activity. This data can take some time to populate, so we are fast forwarding this video to show the points of interest. The logs show you CPU consumption of each process and if it is crossing the threshold. As we can see, the first instance already crossed the threshold and a dump has been generated. This dump is getting copied to the storage account and the bad process is getting terminated. After some time, the other instance also encounters high CPU situation and dumps are collected and the process is killed. This way, the tool captures the data automatically whenever the right condition is satisfied. The data shows up under dumps and report section. After the limit of maximum actions is hit, the rule stops and gives an option to analyze the data. Click on the analyze button to analyze the dumps. You can also download the dumps and run the analysis on your local machine using debug diagnostic tool. Another option to analyze the memory dump is by using our good old trustworthy friend Visual Studio. You can right click the dump and choose open with Visual Studio. Once the dump is loaded in Visual Studio, you see basic information about the dump, like the process name, process bitness. When you scroll to the right, you have the option of debugging managed code or native code. Ours is an ASP.NET application, so I will select debug with managed only. Visual Studio tries to construct the call stack of the first thread in the process. Since the first thread is not managed, we see the message indicating no managed code is running. But need not worry. There is still a lot you can do with this memory dump. You can see all the threads in the process by going to the debug menu, choose Windows, and choose parallel stacks. This option categorizes all managed threads, and we see there are 7 threads with similar call stacks. We see these threads are trying to match some regular expressions. The tree view above shows different states where some threads have progressed starting from this node. If we double-click a stack frame, Visual Studio tries to look up the source for that function. I wanted to simulate a scenario where you may not have debug symbols stored anywhere, and that's why you see this warning indicating that we cannot find the source code. But need not worry. You can click on Decompile Source Code, and that's where the magic happens. Visual Studio decompiles the source code from the dump and is showing you the C# code where the threads are stuck. So the culprit was hiding behind this one line of code, and it was so easy to find. For application developers, this information is like a gold mine because now they know what exactly needs to be fixed. Let's go back to the proactive CPU monitoring page, and by now the dump analysis should have finished. When you launch the report, the tool tries to identify patterns of known issues. In our case, it identified that some threads are using regular expressions. Clicking on the thread number shows us the call stack. Now, this does look familiar, doesn't it? We also see the strings being matched and the regular expression used in the code along with the call stack. At times, debug dog may not identify the exact issue right on the top. You can still navigate to the HTTP context report and look at the long-running requests. Clicking on the thread ID next to the long-running request takes you to the thread where you can view the call stack and the thread activity. This is how you identify threads that are processing active requests and see where they are stuck. So to summarize, CPU monitoring feature allows you to monitor all processes belonging to your site, and it not only mitigates the issue but also collects data to identify the root cause of the problem. Thank you for watching.